Welcome to an introduction to arithmetic and geometric sequences. Let's begin by considering the sequence 3, 7, 11, 15, 19, 23, and so on. By analyzing the sequence, we can see the pattern as we add 4 to each term to get the next term of the sequence. Or we can say the sequence has a common difference since 7 minus 3 is 4, 11 minus 7 is 4, 15 minus 11 is 4, and so on. If the terms of a sequence differ by a constant, then the sequence is called arithmetic. If the initial term of the sequence is a sub 0 equals a, and the common difference is d, then we have the recursive definition that a sub n is equal to a sub n minus 1 plus d, with a sub 0 equal to a, and the closed formula is a sub n equals a plus d times n. Now it is important to recognize here that if the first term is a sub 0, then the closed formula is a sub n equals a sub 0 plus d times n, which is what our textbook uses by letting a sub 0 equal a. But if the first term in the arithmetic sequence is a sub 1, then the closed formula is a sub n equals a sub 1 plus d times the quantity n minus 1. So it is important that we're aware of both of these formulas, because sometimes the first term will be a sub 0, and sometimes it will be a sub 1. Let's take a look at an informal proof for the closed formula for an arithmetic sequence given by a sub n equals a sub 0 plus d times n with the first term a sub 0. Since the common difference d equals a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, this leads to the recursive definition that a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 plus d with a sub 0 as the first term. To find the closed formula, we write out the sequence in general. So the first term is a sub 0. The second term is a sub 1. A sub 1 is equal to a sub 0 plus d. A sub 2 is equal to a sub 1 plus d. But a sub 1 is equal to a sub 0 plus d. And therefore, a sub 2 is equal to a sub 0 plus d, which is a sub 0 plus 2d. A sub 3 is equal to a sub 2 plus d. And we know a sub 2 is equal to a sub 0 plus 2d, which gives us a sub 3 is equal to a sub 0 plus 2d plus d, which is a sub 0 plus 3d. And this pattern continues. To find the nth term, we start with a sub 0 and then add d n times, which gives us the closed formula a sub n equals a sub 0 plus d times n. So again, if we have an arithmetic sequence, the common difference d is equal to a sub n minus a sub n minus 1. And the recursive definition is a sub 0 equals a, and a sub n is equal to a sub n minus 1 plus d. And with a sub 0 equal to a, the closed formula is a sub n equals a plus d times n. Again, this is the formula from our textbook. We'll be using these two formulas here on the right, where this first formula is the same. I just identify the first term as a sub 0 in the formula. So if we go back to the previous sequence, if we let the first term be a sub 0 equals 3, then we know the common difference is equal to 4, and the closed formula is a sub n equals, again, a sub 0 plus d times n, which gives us a sub n equals 3 plus 4 times n. Now, if we let the first term be a sub 1, the closed formula is a little bit different. We have a sub n equals a sub 1 plus d times the quantity n minus 1, which gives us a sub n equals 3 plus 4 times the quantity n minus 1, which simplifies to a sub n equals negative 1 plus 4n. This just emphasizes the importance of knowing whether the first term is identified as a sub 0 or a sub 1. And now let's consider the sequence 3, 12, 48, 192, 768, and so on. By analyzing this sequence, notice how the pattern is we multiply each term in the sequence by 4 to determine the next term in the sequence. Or we can say the sequence has a common ratio, where to find the common ratio, we pick any term in the sequence and divide by the term before it. Notice 12 divided by 3 is 4, 48 divided by 12 is 4, 192 divided by 48 is 4, and so on. And a sequence is called geometric if the ratio between successive terms is constant. So here's an example of a geometric sequence. So suppose the initial term is a sub 0, which equals a, and the common ratio is r, then we have the recursive definition that a sub n is equal to a sub n minus 1 times r, with a sub 0 equal to a. So again, if the first term is a sub 0, then the closed formula for the geometric sequence is a sub n equals a times r to the power of n. But again, I'm going to be more specific and state if the first term is a sub 0, then the closed formula is a sub n equals a sub 0 times r to the power of n. If the first term in the geometric sequence is a sub 1, then we have a sub n equals a sub 1 times r to the power of n minus 1. Let's take a look at an informal proof for the closed formula for a geometric sequence when the first term is a sub 0. So again, the common ratio r is equal to a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1, which leads to the recursive definition that a sub n is equal to a sub n minus 1 times r, with a sub 0 as the first term. So to find the closed formula, we write out the sequence in general. A sub 0 equals a sub 0. A sub 1 is equal to a sub 0 times r. A sub 2 is equal to a sub 1 times r. But a sub 1 is equal to a sub 0 times r. And therefore, a sub 2 is equal to a sub 0 times r, which is a sub 0 times r squared. A sub 3 is equal to a sub 2 times r. And we know a sub 2 is equal to a sub 0 times r squared, giving us a sub 3 equals a sub 0 times r squared times r. And therefore, a sub 3 is equal to a sub 0 times r cubed. And the pattern continues. To find the nth term, we start with a sub 0 and multiply by r n times, which gives us the closed formula a sub n equals a sub 0 times r to the power of n. So again, in general, when we have a geometric sequence, the common ratio r is equal to a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1. The recursive definition is a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 times r, with a sub 0 equal to a. And the closed formula is a sub n equals a times r to the power of n. And again, I'll be more specific and state if the first term is a sub 0, then a sub n is equal to a sub 0 times r to the power of n. And if a sub 1 is the first term, then a sub n is equal to a sub 1 times r to the power of n minus 1. And now let's find the closed formula for the geometric sequence on the previous slide. So if we let the first term be a sub 0 equals 3, we know the common ratio is 4, and therefore the closed formula is a sub n equals a sub 0 times r to the power of n, which gives us a sub n equals 3 times 4 to the power of n. But now if we let the first term be a sub 1, where a sub 1 is equal to 3, then the closed formula is now going to be a sub n equals a sub 1 times r to the power of n minus 1, which gives us a sub n equals 3 times 4 to the power of n minus 1. So these two formulas do give the same geometric sequence. It just depends on whether the first term is a sub 0 or a sub 1. I hope you found this helpful.